First John chapter 3, verse 2. Beloved, now are we the sons of Yahweh, and it do not yet appear what we shall be. But we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. I want to give our praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Rakah, Kodash, forgive me the spirit to do this lesson. This is a part two from my last lesson. And in this lesson, I'm going to go into the appearance of lightning. Okay, the appearance of lightning. Okay, and when you read that, that has something to do with our new look, with our changed bodies. Okay, with getting the image of the heavenly man. Okay, bearing their image, Yahabashi Mahashai, and the angels. Okay, so let's read this again. First John chapter 3, verse 2. Beloved, now are we the sons of Yahweh, and it do not yet appear what we shall be. Right, we don't know yet. Okay, the scriptures give us details to meditate and hope, okay, and be excited about. But when you actually see it, it's going to blow your mind. Okay, even though we have these details in the scriptures, okay. But we know that when he shall appear, Yahushua, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Right, man, we're going to see him exactly how he is, like he's sitting right now in the heavens up there, man. Okay, on the right-hand side of the throne. We're going to see him just like that, like he is. Okay, now, who does he look like? Okay, what image did he get? Let's read, all right? Let's go into Hebrews chapter 1, verse 3. Who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, Yahushua being the brightness of Yahweh's glory. So Yahushua is the brightness of Yahweh's glory, but then we're going to be changed into him. Okay, to his image. But he has the Most High image. So you put that together, all right? And upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. Right, man. Now, let's go into the blue letter. Okay, we're going to go into brightness, the word brightness, and the word express image. Okay? Let's start with brightness. All right?
Strong's G 541. Apalgasma. Apalgasma.
Now it says reflection brightness. Okay. Of Yahweh Shai, in that he perfectly reflects the majesty of Yahweh. Perfectly. Okay. Keep that in mind. It also says shining forth of a light coming from a luminous body. Now, keep that in mind, because this is a key point that's going to carry on into this lesson. OK, it says shining forth of a light coming from a luminous body outring. OK, like rays. OK, so keep that in mind as I keep reading. All right. Now, let's go into the express image in the blue letter and go into this word.
Strong's G 5481 character. Character.
Okay. Let's get to the point on this. It says the exact expression, the image of any person or thing, marked likeness, precise reproduction in every respect. Ooh, wee. Precise. Like precisely. Reproduction in every respect. Right, so Yahweh Shai is the exact express image, okay, of Yahweh, okay? But it said, we shall be like him. So do you not understand when Yahweh Shai told them in the scriptures say ye are gods, he was not playing, man. Because he knows that the elect, that Jacob, is ultimately going to be changed into his father's image and his image, man, okay? Turn into a god. All right. Now, a quick point I forgot on the word, the brightness. When you go back into the blue letter, I'm gonna go back into it. It says shining forth of a light coming from a luminous body. Now, when you go into the Google definition on luminous, check out what it says. It says a natural light given body, especially the sun or moon. Read it again. A natural light given body, especially the sun Amun. He had an aura, okay? The same beauty and aura that Yahweh has, Yahweh Shah got it, okay? And that's what we want. And we're going to see what it looks like if you make it, man. We're close. You're going to see if you change. Now, check this out. Let's go to Daniel chapter 10, verse 6. It says, his body also was like the beryl, and his face as the appearance of lightning. Talking about Yahweh Shah. So his face had the appearance of lightning. So when you think about lightning, what do you see? You see this glow, this magnificent light. Okay, a shining, a brightness, man. Okay, and it looks beautiful, man. All right. Even when you scared, you a little kid, you scared of a thunderstorm, and you see lightning, you're like, oh man. But once you lay eyes on the lightning, okay, you're like, man, that's beautiful, man. Okay, I love the look of lightning. Okay, because it comes from the heavens. So put this together. Okay, put this together, man. And his face as the appearance of lightning, and his eyes as lamps of fire, and his arms and his feet in color to polished brass. Right, man, polished brass. Imagine polished brass, man. Very, very shiny, just beautiful, man. Immortal skin. We ain't got that right now, man. You got pimples and wrinkles and all jacked up, ashy. You ain't got that, all right? I don't care how much shea butter you put on. All right? So it says, in the voice of his words, like the voice of a multitude. Now, let's go into lightning in this scripture in the blue letter in Daniel chapter 10, verse 6. Now, check this out.
Strong's H1300. Barak. Barak.
Okay. And it says lightning. Okay. Lightnings. Lightning flashes. You hear that? Lightning. Lightnings. Lightning flashes, man. Okay. Bright. You see that? A gleam. All right. So they have an aura around them, man, that separates them from us, from mortals. They are immortal. Okay. So they have an immortal shine, an immortal glow as the appearance of lightning, man. Okay. That's what we're going to get. We're going to get that, man. Man, the Lord is going to deck us out, man. Okay. He's going to deck us out. Okay. It talks about having a light inside of you, right? The truth, the wisdom. Okay. But we're going to receive both. We're going to receive the light, that perfect righteous spirit. He's going to put the law in our inward parts. Okay, we ain't gonna go off. We ain't gonna mess up. We ain't gonna be evil no more ever again. And then on the outside, he's gonna give us that glow, that light in the physical appearance, just like him, just like Yahweh Shai. Okay, and the angels. All right, can't make that up, man. Now, check this out. When you go into Matthew chapter 28, you start at verse 1. Check this out. It says, in the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn toward the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulcher, okay, where Yahweh Shah was supposed to be at, all right? And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. His countenance was like lightning. So here it is. We heard about Yahweh's countenance being like lightning, okay? Because Yahweh Shah has the exact image, the express image of Yahweh. Okay. So we've seen Yahweh Shah has the appearance of lightning, his face. And we're reading about one of his brothers, the angels, descending down from the heavens. Okay. And it says, verse 3, his countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. Right, man. Ain't no dingy white. You talking about white as snow. And when you look at snow, man, it has those sparkles in it, man. So his garment was also sparkling, okay? Because snow sparkles. Like little small, little diamonds, little crystal diamonds put together, man. When you see a whole street or a whole house covered with snow, man, it's a beautiful, beautiful look. Beautiful look, okay? So it says, his countenance was like lightning. Let's go into that in the blue letter and see what it says. Okay, we're going to put this together, man. All right, you should be very, very excited meditating about this. Now, I read about the gleam and the light, okay, in the other scriptures.
Strong's G 796. Astrape.
Okay, it says lightning of the gleam of a lamp. Right, man. The aura, man. They had a light aura around them. Okay? And this is the angel, man. So his face was the appearance of lightning, man. Why? Because he also has the image of the heavenly, man. They don't have the image of the earthy. Okay? It's a huge difference from mortals to immortals when we talk about image here. That's inside and outside, not just inside. And outside is a difference. Okay? Overall, the whole pie. Okay? Now let's keep reading that. Okay? Because it's a point I want to make. So back at Matthew 28, verse 3. His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment white as snow. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake. Right, the guards that were guarding the sepulcher, man. Okay, guarding it where Yahweh Shah was at. So it says, and for fear of him, the keepers did shake. They were scared and became as dead men. Right, man. They fainted. They passed out, man. They became as dead men. It shook them. Okay, think about that. Now, why did they shake? For one, the angel descend down and came out of nowhere. But the look, okay, the look was so out of this world. Okay, it was not a mortal look. They saw that aura around that angel, man. They're like, what the hell? Shaking, scared. You know, stomach fell like their ass when they saw that, man. Okay, so when you go back to my first lesson on part one, when it talks about them coming before our feet, saying, surely God is in thee. They're going to see that and they're going to shake. All right? They're going to shake. They're going to be scared. Okay? Begging for their life. Trying to plead their cause. Okay? So this look is going to shake people up because it's not mortal. This is not a earthy look. Get the earthy look out your mind, man. Okay? Look at yourself in the mirror. All right? When you get changed, kiss that nigga goodbye. We're going to get changed into righteousness. Okay, we are filth right now. We are filth. You got to recognize that. All right? Now, when you go to Revelation chapter 4, it's a point I want to make that's going to really connect this, man. So let's go to Revelation chapter 4. Let me start verse 1. After this, I looked, and behold, a door was open in heaven, and the first voice which I heard was as it were of a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show thee things which must be hereafter. And immediately I was in the spirit, and behold, a throne was set in heaven, and one sat on the throne. So John the Revelator is getting the vision of Yahweh sitting on the throne, man. And he's going to break it down to us what he sees. Verse 3. And he that sat was to look upon like a jasper and a sardine stone. Right, man. Okay. And you know, stones are beautiful. But hey, Lord willing, I can go into the stones in part 3. Lord willing. Okay. And there was a rainbow round about the throne and a sight like unto an emerald. And round about the throne were 40 and 20 seats, talking about the elder angels. And upon the seats I saw 24 elder angels clothed in white raiment. And they had on their heads crowns of gold. Check this out. And out of the throne, where the Most High is sitting, Yahweh, proceedeth lightnings and thunderings. And voices, and there were 7 lamps of fire burning before the throne, which are the 7 spirits of Yahweh. Now let's go into lightning in this scripture, man, in the blue letter. Let's get it. First, let's go into proceedeth. Okay, then we go into the lightning. Okay, because that's a point. So let's go into proceedeth in this scripture.
Strong's G 1607, Ekparuomai.
Okay, it says to go forth, to come forth, to proceed, okay, to project from one's mouth, to spread abroad. Okay, so what projected, what came forth? All right, let's see. Let's go into lightnings, because that's what came forth out from the throne, out from Yahweh, okay? Because he also has the appearance of lightning. okay, in true lightning. All right? Check this out. It says lightning of gleams of a lamp. It says the same thing. Okay, why? Because Yahweh Shai has his image. The angels have his image. And we want that image because that is the heavenly image. It is a separation between us and the mortals. We're not going to be mortal no more, man. But everybody else is. The Lord going to make a separation, man, between his people and the rest of the people. Okay? It's going to be undeniable. Undeniable, man. Now, when you go into Ezekiel chapter 1, I'm going to get to the point. Now, this whole chapter goes into the angels and the chariots, the wheel within the wheel, just so you know. Okay, you can read it yourself, the whole chapter, but I'm going to go to verse 13. It says, as for the likeness of the living creatures, their appearance was like burning coals of fire. Okay, the creatures talking about the angels. And like the appearance of lamps, it went up and down among the living creature. Right, a gleam, a glow. You see that? And the fire was bright. And out of the fire went forth lightning. Right, proceedeth out. Okay, that's why when an angel descended down before Mary and Mary Magdalene, it said that he had the appearance, his countenance was as the appearance of lightning, man. Like lightning flashes, like a glow, like an aura. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that, man? So you mean to tell me you got stones on you, pure stones, gold. You have the look of the heavenly. You have glow of auras and lightnings and just like something out of this world, man. Something out of this world. You can't make this up. It all connects. It all connects. Okay. Now, my last point I want to make to end this. Let's go into Exodus chapter 34. Let's start at verse 28. It says, and he was there with the Lord 40 days and 40 nights. Talking about Moses. Okay. When he was getting the commandments. All right. He did neither eat nor drink water. He wrote upon the tables the words of the covenant, the Ten Commandments. And it came to pass when Moses came down from Mount Sinai with the two tables of testimonies in Moses' hand, when he came down from the mount, that Moses wist not that the skin of his face shined while he talked with him. Right, man. His skin shined, man. Did it not say that Yahweh Shai was as the appearance of lightning? It had that shine, it had that gleam, it had that glow. Okay, it had that lightning look and aura. But Moses didn't know it. So it said that Moses wist not that the skin of his face shine while he talked with him. And when Aaron and all the children of Israel saw Moses, behold, the skin of his face shine. And they were afraid to come near him. They were afraid, like, what the? Okay, and that same shine is what those keepers of the house saw when they passed out, when the angel descended down, because that look, that gleam is the image of the heavenly. Okay, starting with Yahweh to Yahweh Shai and to the rest of the angels. Okay, so when Moses was talking with the Most High, okay, that aura came on him. Okay, and this is in his mortal state. Okay, Yahweh made it come on him, man, and he made it stick on him. So when he went to the rest of Israel, they was like, what the heck? Yeah, you better listen. Oh, boy. It said, and they were afraid to come near him. All right. And Moses called unto them, and Aaron and all the rulers of the congregation returned unto him, and Moses talked with them. And afterward, all the children of Israel came nigh. He gave them in commandment all that the Lord had spoken with him in Mount Sinai. Until Moses had done speaking with them, he put a veil on his face. Right, because it was shining that bright, man. Okay? Because they were distracted. They were scared. They didn't want to come near. So he put a veil over his face just to calm them down to talk to them. What does that tell you right there? What does that tell you? That when we talk about the immortal image and heavenly image, it is pure power. And when you see it as pure power. Okay? It has nothing to do with the earth. Keep that in mind. It has nothing to do with the earth. Yahweh Shem HaWashah is bringing that spirit from up there and that image from up there. And he's bringing it down to the earth because the kingdom of heaven is coming. Okay? His kingdom. the kingdom of heaven, then that image is going to be seen. Okay? And all the nations going to know, like, man, these are gods. These are gods. They going to know it, man. Okay, like I read in my first lesson. Surely God is in thee. Now let's go into the blue letter on shine. Okay? In the scriptures with Moses. Okay? Check this out to end it.
Strong's H, 7160. Karan. Karan.
Okay, it says to shine. To send out rays. Do you hear that? To send out rays. Okay. Lightnings, gleams. All right. Brightness. So Moses had the same thing on him. And you know he did because he didn't have it on him until after he talked to the Most High, who has that image, who gave it to Yahweh Shai and the rest of the angels, man. And that's the image we want. Okay. And we're going to be fully in the image, man. He just gave Israel a taste, okay, of how out of the world it looks by making a gleam. Okay, his gleam shine on Moses, which at the time was a mortal man. So think about that, man. So the appearance of lightning goes into the glow, the aura around the bodies, the immortal bodies. All right. So I hope you were edified. You know, hey, you might have some dreams about it, man. Hey, if you do, share them. But this is heavy, man. Okay? That's when it talks about the weight of glory can't compare to your suffering. When you compare it, it's no comparison, man. The weight of glory that's coming to us is going to be unbelievable. Okay? So with that, I hope you're edified. I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah, Kodash, for giving me the spirit to do this lesson. Double honors to the elders of the great millstone. And shalom to you, Akamai, through this doing the truth and sincerity. Shalom.